All right, hello everybody and welcome back to another Deepvue tutorial. Today we'll be talking about how to create a CANSLIM template that you can use throughout Deepvue in the dashboard, screener, deep list, and of course the alerts module over here. We'll be starting pretty much from scratch, so if you're completely new to Deepvue, this is a perfect video to watch. We'll talk about how to add indicators, how to add the data panel, earnings and sales stats table as well. So keep watching until the end. I'm sure you'll pick up a few new tips and tricks when it comes to getting started with Deepvue. And if you do enjoy this video, please go ahead and leave a like down below, subscribe if you're new to the channel. And if you haven't tried Deepvue yet, we've got a special offer for first-time users, 2 months for $39. You can basically take advantage of that offer by clicking the link down below in the description, as well as popping up right now. With that said, you can see we've got pretty much the a blank slate here. We've got just price action candlesticks here in Deepvue. And very quickly, we're gonna turn this into the ideal CANSLIM template with moving averages, the relative strength line, earnings and sales, volume, the works. So let's go ahead and get started. First things first, let's go ahead and add the moving averages that we're gonna wanna use. And to add an indicator in Deepvue, what you wanna do is click the indicators and strategies icon right here. And then let's go ahead and search DV. By the way, this is where all our indicators are stored. So if you wanna scroll through the basically hundreds of indicators that you have to choose from here, you've got full customizability. You can take a look at that. But just for the purposes of this tutorial, we'll be talking about really just the CANSLIM specific ones. So first things first, we'll type in DV to bring up our specialized indicators. We've got a lot here. Net new highs, new lows, earnings line, sales line. We'll have indicators, basically indicator tutorials for all of these coming up pretty shortly. But what we want here is the key moving averages indicator right here. And if you want a favorite indicator, so it shows up on the initial screen, you can always star it just like that. And let's go ahead and add it to our charts by clicking it right here. So there we go. You can see the basic ones have been added, the presets, the default ones. And in order to edit any indicator in Deepvue, what you wanna do is hover over that indicator in this tree, this object tree. You'll see all your indicators down here, and then click the gear icon. This brings up the different settings here. We've got input, style, and visibility, basically what time frames you wanna see this indicator on. And you can see that you can edit up to 5 intraday moving averages, a bunch of daily ones, weekly, as well as monthly ones. So you can basically set the defaults for all of those. We're really gonna be focused on the daily and weekly. You can definitely, of course, tailor this to whatever you would like on the intraday, all the way up to the monthly charts. So let's go ahead and set our daily moving averages. We're just gonna have the 21 EMA. So let's go ahead and uncheck this one, check this one, and change this over to an EMA. That's moving average 3. Moving average 2, we're gonna uncheck and we're gonna check the 50 SMA here. We'll change the colors in just a second. And let's go ahead and add the 200-day moving average. You can see it updating in real time over here on the daily chart. For weekly, 10 and 40 is good. And we're gonna skip the intraday and monthly ones, but if you'd like to add those and set defaults, you can do that and set it up just like we will the rest of these. So with that said, let's go over to style. And for daily, we have MA3, MA5, and MA7 active. So those are the ones we really care about. The 21 EMA, I like to set at purple. The 50-day, I like to set as red. And the 200-day moving average, I like to set as black. That's kind of my preference. Obviously, you can set it up exactly how you would like it, but that looks pretty good. And on the weekly, looks like we have MA1 and 4 active. I'm just kind of checking which ones to edit the style of here. And MA1, we're gonna set that also to red. And then MA4, we'll set to black. So now if you switch over to a weekly time frame, we'll see these ones also corresponding to those colors. And I like kind of lining up the 10-week with the 50-day and the 40-week with that 200-day, have it be the same color. Basically, it serves as a good reference point. So that's pretty much it in terms of the styling. Visibility, I kind of leave to standard. I just wanted to show up on all time frames. Obviously, you can set it up so this moving average wouldn't show up on, for instance, an intraday time frame if you would like that. But once you've got all the inputs and style things checked, you just press OK. But just one more thing As we go into here, just taking a look at all the options, you can increase the thickness of stuff, you can change the opacity, you can add a different color if you'd like to. So you've got full customizability options when it comes to the look and feel of these moving averages. So let's go ahead and press OK. We've got the moving averages that we want already set. And if we change this time frame by clicking this D icon to a weekly, you can see that we've automatically got that 10 and 40 week moving average. Really nice and handy to use this Deepvue key moving averages indicator. And going over to the time frame, if you want to kind of save time frames up there, for instance, the daily and weekly, you can favorite those right there. And then quickly you can switch in between them just like that. So that's perfect. Now let's go ahead and add volume. Let's go ahead and search volume. And let's go ahead and move that to a new pane below just so it's not covering price. And to do that, we go over to the volume indicator on the object tree and click these three dots and say move to new pane below. And that separates it. You can basically drag this up and down to resize volume. And you can edit the look of volume by once again going over to the gear icon. And you can change the colors. You can add a volume moving average. So let's make that black as well. And you can click this and change how it looks as well. You can do a histogram of that moving average area, however you would like it. I personally like just a simple line there. So that looks pretty good. And you can change the MA length over here from 20 to 50 if you'd like to. Basically, that's up to your personal preference. The smoothing length doesn't matter too much for that moving average. You can just set that to 1, and we want it to show up on all those time frames. So we'll go ahead and just press OK. But if you would like to hide it on a particular time frame, you can go ahead and choose that right there. So we've got our key moving averages. Let's go back to a daily chart. We've got volume. Now we want to add the relative strength line and then talk earnings and sales and the data panel. So let's go ahead over to once again, indicators and strategies. Let's type DV. And then let's find the relative strength line. There we go. And you can see how it's kind of scaled the chart there. That's because right now it's scaling the RS line along with the price chart. And we want to kind of scale those independently. So there's kind of two different options here. We can either move the RS line to a different pane, or we can move it to a different scale. What I personally like to do is move it to a new pane above, but I'll also show you kind of how to do the different scale as well. So let's go ahead and move it back to the pane below. So if you want to just add it to a different scale, so you can kind of move it around your price chart a little bit more independently, you can pin to a new right scale or pin it to a new left scale. We'll go ahead and do a right scale. And now you can see that the price chart is being scaled, but this is kind of staying independent. You can kind of resize things. Also kind of move it up and down just like that. So this can suit your preferences if you like this, but I personally prefer to move it to a new pane above. And you can see the options here, just looking at the RS line, we've got the moving average that you can change. We highlight the areas above and below the moving average, and we've got RS new high before price. We've also got price new high highlighted in these circles. So to view those settings, just like the previous ones, we go over to the gear icon by hovering over the indicator, clicking that, and you can go over to inputs. You've got different plot types for the RS line. You can even see it in a candlestick format, which can be pretty handy. You can change the moving average that you're using as the signal line. You can add another moving average if you'd like to. You can hide the different functions here. Green dot corresponds to an RS line new high. A pink dot corresponds to a new high before price. You can also hide different moving averages, just like that. So it's very easy. Going over to style, you can basically change everything about it, the colors of everything. And one more thing, we've got the crossover indicator. So you can see this triangle here. When we cross above that signal line, you can add in an icon there. So you've got a lot of flexibility with this RS line, and it's definitely pretty handy for judging that RS, especially when the market is correction. If you see this line increasing, that's a good tell that you've got a potential leader on your hands. All right, so we've got the price chart, we've got the moving averages, volume, and RS line. What's next is to add in the CANSLIM element of looking at the fundamentals as well. So the first thing we're going to do is add the quarterly earnings and sales growth data. And to do that, we want to add our stats table and toggle that on by going up to this icon here and clicking it. This brings up the stats table, and we'll actually zoom in just a touch here so you can see it a little bit more clearly. And to do that, we're going to go ahead up here and click the stats table icon. And this will bring up the earnings and sales data going back, and also estimates. You can scroll left and right here to see more historical or more estimates. We've often got, you know, 5 quarters, 6 quarters, sometimes 8 quarters in advance. You can really see the projections in terms of what earnings and sales growth is supposed to be. So you can hover over any posted quarter. You can see the reported value, the estimate, the growth surprise, either in percentage or dollar amount. And you can see the estimates going into the future. So this is really handy to see kind of the quarterly values along with the price chart right there. And if you prefer kind of a vertical view for this, what we can do is toggle on the data panel. You'll have kind of a default template that looks something like this. And you can see that in the defaults, we've actually created this for you. You've got the Deepvue EPS rating, as well as the annual numbers right here in terms of EPS estimates, as well as sales right here. And if down here, if you want to take a look at annual, you can click this icon. I forgot to say this, but you can switch this over to annual. You can also show 4 years versus 8 years. You can do the same with quarterly numbers, 4 quarters versus 8 quarters. Basically, whatever you prefer. You know, it's often good to eliminate some noise and really focus on what's critical to your process. You can also hide different options right here, but that's how you toggle in between quarterly and annual values right there. So here in the data panel, all of this is fully customizable, all these fields. This is just kind of the default template that we create there for you. But if you want to create a quarterly kind of vertical view of this, what you would want to do is go ahead and click edit, and we'll go ahead and click plus, and we're going to go ahead and add a category, which is basically adding a box right here, and we'll call this EPS quarterly. Click save. That's created right here, and then we'll go ahead and search EPS. And you can either scroll here, or you can basically, you know, search as well. We'll go ahead and add the latest reported quarter, 2 quarters ago, 4 quarters ago, and this is the raw number. And if you want to do growth, you can go ahead and look for that as well. Quarterly EPS growth. We'll actually X these out because I care more about the growth versus the reported value. And we'll go ahead and check these, get 4 quarters. And there we go. We've got the EPS there. Let's do sales now. Scroll down. And we want the growth again. So latest reported 2 quarters ago, 3 quarters ago, and 4 quarters ago. And there we go. That's pretty much it. So now if we X out here, we've got the same growth number that's reported down here. Now in a vertical format, you can switch this between a two column view versus just a single column, whatever kind of suits your main style. Exit out, you can add it back. Sometimes you want to prefer to look at the chart. Sometimes maybe on the weekends you want to dive, you know, a deeper view into this data panel here. So that's pretty much it for setting up the CANSLIM template. Just to summarize everything we did, we added the key moving averages that are critical to the CANSLIM system. A lot of people use the 21 EMA. The 50 SMA, of course, is a spot for potential institutional support. We'll see if NVIDIA obeys that during this move. We've got the 200-day to judge that longer-term trend. We've got the relative strength line to judge the RS of a potential leadership stock. We've got earnings and sales both shown down here, as well as we've got the data panel view if you prefer this vertical format. So that's pretty much it for this video. Let us know if you have any questions down below. Give Deepvue a try if you haven't yet, and look forward to seeing your feedback. Please leave a like down below if you enjoyed, subscribe if you're new to the channel, and we'll see you guys in future videos. Take care.